practice with lessons for another lick of the week. In today's session, I'm going to be sharing with you a very cool progressive style blues lick that you can perform over the 1-4 change inside your 12-bar blues. So in the key of A, that would be going from A7 to D7. Now, I'm going to get started reviewing the scales that the lick comes from, then I'll break it down for you step by step. I got a tab for you at patreon.com/swiftlessons. I strongly recommend that you become a member there so you can gain access to a ton of extra resources for all my popular YouTube guitar lessons. Now, let's get started. Okay, close look at the fretboard, getting started reviewing our source scales, the major and minor pentatonics. Now these are two patterns that are very useful for blues and rock improvisation and are frequently used in tandem. Getting started with the major pentatonic in the key of A, it's going to look and sound like this. Okay, so that was the 5th fret, low E string, the A note getting us started, a whole step up to B, then we're going to have the 4th fret of the A string, C sharp, going up to E, 7th fret, F sharp on the D string, 4th fret, and then the 7th fret of the D string, back to A, that's one octave right there. So A, B, C sharp, E, F sharp, and A. 5 notes of the major scale in the key of A, so that's why they call it penta. All right, the next octave, we're gonna have the 4th fret of the G string, up a whole step. Then we're gonna have the 5th fret of the B string, 7th fret, and then the same thing on the high E string, 5th fret to 7th fret. You put all that together and we have. Okay, now taking a look at the minor pentatonic scale. It's gonna look and sound like this. Okay, I'm pretty sure all of you probably know this already, but it never hurts to review. That is going to be the 5th fret, low E string, going up to 8, 5-7 on the A string, 5-7 on the D string, and that's one octave. A, C, D, E, G, A. Okay, those are the notes inside your minor pentatonic scale in the key of A. All right, then the next octave is going to be more of the same. We have 5-7 on the G string, 5-8 on the B string, and then 5-8 on the high E string. Put all that together and we have. Okay, very good everybody. You have those two scales down, play them over and over again in repetition, build the muscle memory. Once you have them down, then you can start trying to blend them together. High level blues players mix these two scales together in very specific ways. So not every single combination of notes is going to sound bluesy. Things like... All right, climbing up that major pentatonic scale. And then going from the minor third to the major third. That's really one of the most bluesy things that you can do. Okay, finding some notes here on the B and high E strings. That minor third again. Okay, so many different possibilities when you're combining those two scales together. Okay, very good everybody. With your source scales firmly committed to muscle memory, let's put them to work with this advanced transition lick. Now, when you're learning these licks, remember, it's best to break everything up into small bits, being sure to count as you proceed through the measure. Practice slow, patient, and with careful repetitions. Okay, the lick's gonna sound like this, nice and slow. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and... dropping you off right on the 4 chord. Okay, and even slower with the count. A 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 1. Okay, so this lick sounds a little outside. There's one note that is featured that's not a part of the scale that adds a ton of tension. Let's break this up. Okay, so in our backing track, we had the A shuffle, two measures, and then the D. This transition lick is for the second measure of the A going into the first measure of the D chord. It starts off on beat number two. All right, that was 2 and 7 and 7 with the pinky and the ring finger. Okay, it's very important that I use those fingers so I can reach. So 7 and 7, 4 on the D string, and then 7 on the D string. Very common movement in blues music. I'm gonna try to get my pick alternating now. All right, then we're gonna get a little weird here. We're gonna go outside the scale and go up a half step, slide in. 1 and 2 and 3 and. Okay, so that sounds very intense, and it's supposed to be that way. It kind of drives the listener into expecting the next chord. So. All right, then we're going to do that minor third, major third. All right, so that was 5 to 6. All right, so far you have. Okay, Uma sounds Eastern, right? 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. All right, then we're gonna have 5 and 5, B string and high E string, barring. And then on beat number one of the next measure, we're landing on a note that is inside of the D major chord. Okay, so that's going to be the 7th fret of the B string. Put all that together and we have 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Okay, and it's very, very important that you practice counting it as you learn the lick. At first, you're gonna be playing this in a very robotic fashion. It's not going to seem instinctual, but the more you play it, the more you count it, the more you'll be able to judge where exactly this lick goes, and then after some time, you'll be able to just kind of throw it in more instinctually, more intuitively. Okay, so one more time, you put it all together, we have 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Okay, very cool, slightly bizarre, progressive blues lick for a 1-4 transition. Okay, very good everybody. You have your scales, you have that transition lick down. Just one last little tip. I did play a lick that was kind of interesting on the first measure in my demonstration. It sounded like this. Okay, so let's use that as kind of a bonus lick for y'all. Okay, so right on the one beat, bending the minor third, that 5th fret of the G string, and going to the root note A. I'll rake on it sometimes, or I'll double stop. All right, then a note that is a part of the blues scale, the flatted 5th, we call this interval. Another tense note. That's something that I really like to include in my playing. Very intense notes that are a little outside sounding. Then I'll go to the flatted 7th. That's the 5th fret of the D string. And then go back up to the root. All right, excellent lick. Very beginner friendly. A great way to set up the transition lick that we have, because it sounds a little outside too, so they match and sound very good together side by side. Okay, and if you put those side by side over two measures of A7, it sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and okay, a great way to fill up two measures of A7 going to D7. All right, friends, thanks so much for checking out this lick of the week. I hope you enjoyed it. Big thanks to my patrons for all your support. Thank you so much for making these lessons possible. I've got many more videos coming up, so keep checking back. Please subscribe, please share. This is Rob at Swift Guitar Lessons in Philadelphia, saying happy picking.